am all a tingle. There is a big party at the White House tonight. Barack Obama is welcoming India's Prime Minister to the United States. There he is, walking very, very strangely and slowly. The Obamas are hosting their first state dinner, and what a dinner it'll be. They're going to have a large tent built on the South Lawn to host the 300-plus guests who are invited. Do we not have room in the White House? I don't have a problem with the state dinners, and I want to make that very, very clear. President Bush usually kept his guest list to 200. Obama is having his first one at 300, but President Clinton has been at 700 people at these things. But tonight, singer and actress Jennifer Hudson is expected to perform. And Politico is reporting that Hollywood director M. Night Shyamalan will be in attendance. Skitty. And Steven Spielberg is going to be there. Jeffrey Katzenberg, CEO of DreamWorks Animation. It's going to be fantastic. Sounds great. Maybe a little too great. I mean, don't get me wrong. Again, no problem with state dinners. It is important to show the leaders of the world, even those who walk very slowly and weirdly, to, you know, show them courtesy and respect. We would expect that from for our leaders when they go abroad. But with the rest of the world freaking out that we're spending too much money, we're in the middle of a major recession. You know, it's an emergency, remember. Can we not? Wouldn't it be good to show, you know, the world leaders that we're toning things down a bit? I mean, have some tact and tone down the parties. Maybe not the state dinners, but let me put in perspective what this president has been up to this year and what the country has been going through. This is you, no party. This is them, party. Here it is. You ready? Let's roll the presidential party pictures while we go through this. First, January 20th, he went to the inauguration, and of course he had the party. 10 official balls. Cool. He just did get inaugurated, and he deserved it, and that's fine. Everybody has one. January 28th, bipartisan cocktail party. After the House passed the president's stimulus package with no Republican support, so it wasn't really bipartisan, but it was a party. February 1st, the Super Bowl party. Of course, you know, who doesn't have a Super Bowl party? Everybody does. Oh, February 6th, unemployment hit 7.6%. Chrysler says on February 17th that they need more money down here to survive, a lot more than they originally thought, and GM receives $4 billion in government loans. On February 27th, the governor's party, yeah, with Earth, Wind, and Fire, rock on. Then on February 26th, Stevie Wonder celebration. Who doesn't love Stevie Wonder? March 4th, congressional party for 2,000 leaders and their spouses in the East Room. Yet another party. The president, in fact, joked at this one, that's a pretty big house and we get so lonely. Maybe they should get another dog and spend about 17 months deciding which one to buy. March 6th, unemployment up to 8.1%. China proposes a major overhaul of the global monetary system. They explain a little pesky thing about how the dollar could be replaced as the world's main reserve currency because we were spending too much money. Unemployment was at 8.5%, you know, and then unemployment went to 8.9%. But then on May 12th, we had a poetry party. I love those. Then on May 30th, New York City date night. Had to go out and date, you know, in New York City. Had to fly up here. $24,000 of your money. What do you say you get a video? I'm just saying. June 5th, unemployment. 9.4. But June 24th, the luau at the White House. Remember that? That was great. They dug a big hole there in the. Usually it's just a congressional picnic, but this year it was a luau. I bet we didn't spend any money really at all digging a big hole there in the White House lawn and then making it look perfect the next day. And then, of course, unemployment was 9.5. July 4th, Independence Day. That was the party, of course. You got that one. Then July 22nd, we had a country music party. And then July 27th, we had cash for clunkers, which didn't really go well. July 30th, we had $1 billion, and we were running out. And the Obama administration said, oh, I guess we need to do that one again. And then August 7th, Obama signed legislation that devoted more than $2 billion more to that program. And on that same day, 9.4% unemployment. But then he went right to Martha's Vineyard. So that was great. Then August 25th, the White House and the Congressional Budget Office forecast that our debt will nearly double over the next 10 years, which is fantastic. And so we had that big debt thing. But then we went right to unemployment at 9.7%. And then in October, we went...
We're running out of time here.
What? No, there's a lot of parties. We had astronomy night. We had an astronomy. We had Fiesta Latina, which was great. And we had all, you know, they were all there. And then we had the unemployment. It was fantastic. What do you say, just until these things go away, we just kind of tone down some of these things? For the past 2 years, News Corp has canceled its Christmas party because it's not fair to the shareholders who have lost money in this down economy. Don't you think it looks a little tacky? What do you say in Washington we begin to lead by example? The way when President Bush played golf during the war, the left was up in arms, so he stopped. Well, guess what? Obama has golfed 25 times since he took office. It took Bush almost 3 years to golf that much. I don't really care about golfing. I really don't. The president needs some time off. He needs to go to Martha's Vineyard. But what do you say we stop with the double standard? What do you say again? Until these clear up, we tone these down just because I think it's in poor taste. Back in a second.